Alright, I just wanted to show you a couple of the things I have for processing meat and stuff like that. This is a little hand crank unit, and it's a universal, this is the brand number 323 meat chopper. It's got the fine cutting disc on it, as you can see there. And it's made by LF&C, New Britain, Connecticut, USA. I was talking to a friend of the family at a family get together, and we were just talking how I had made homemade sauce with the machine and all that, and he says, I got a meat chopper that I don't use, so you can have it. So I got it. So it's pretty simple how it works. I'll take it apart here to show you. Haven't never used it yet, even though I just recently made sausage because I used a different machine. But I'll show it to you. Unscrew this little piece from the handle. And we got the auger here. It's kind of like a corkscrew type of thing. Feeds the meat in one direction as you crank it clockwise. It's got a knife inside it with four blades. You see that? It's a little one. This is a pretty small machine. And then this is the cutter that I was showing you when it was still attached. These are like about 1/8 inch holes. It's probably best for like ground beef. Obviously the handle. It was actually made in the USA. And then this holds it all in place. And it even tells you which direction to tighten and loosen it in if you don't know. Which, if you don't know, you shouldn't be cutting meat. Unless it was like, you know, the reverse of normal threading. Why mention it? I don't know. Whatever. Alright, so this is the little machine. And I might use it, you know, because the other two machines that I have don't have this small a cutter. So if I had to make anything that fine, grind anything that fine, I'd either have to go and find a company that sells these for my machines and buy one for that, or just use this. But this one's manual. I have another manual one that's bigger, and I have the sausage stuffer that goes on that one, and then I have a motorized one, which I will show you in a minute. So let me show you how this goes back together. Put the auger in there, put your handle on, screw that on, that keeps the auger from moving, and you put your knife in, like so, and then you gotta lock it in there. And you put your cutter in and spin it until it lines up with the key there, and then screw that down. And you don't want to make it too tight, because I've noticed that if it's too tight, you can't, it won't spin freely. And then you just screw it on to, you know, a table like this. With the crank. Put a pan under here and grind away. Alright, so that's that one.
Be right back with machine number 2.